Mr. Speaker,
the President of the United States.
Hello, this is Mark Del Sasso. A presidential address to both houses of Congress is a unique event. It's an attention getter. So I thought we'd start off there and start with something dramatic. I would like to talk in this video about the shooting of the president's room on the Senate side of the U.S. Capitol. This shoot was commissioned in 2005. We started pre-production in 2005 and did most of the shooting in 2006. I've done to date about 50 different shoots on the U.S. Capitol grounds over a period of 25 years. Some of them personal, some of them commercial. I taught a photography class there for a long time. I was very, very knowledgeable about the natural lighting, the artificial lighting at the U.S. Capitol inside and out. And that all came to bear in this shoot. We shot 25, a couple dozen different areas that were designated as part of the multimedia tour that now resides in the Capitol Visitor Center Museum. So most of this work is all there if you want to see more of it. But I'd like to just look at the president's room, because the assembly technique that was used there was the template for essentially everything that was done for the whole Capitol shoot. We used the same methods, same techniques again and again and again. I was really, really pleased with this work. So much of my life went into this actual shoot. It was very, very important that it went smoothly. The president's room for me was a special place. I had first accessed it around 1990 in a shoot with Senator Strom Thurmond. And I had never actually known anything about the room historically or what it was used for. It's off the beaten path. It's not easily accessible. You need a congressional staffer really to kind of get you in there. You need an appointment. It's a small space. It was finished around 1860 and served as the area where the President of the United States would sign legislation into law as the congressional session ended. And it's functioned in that purpose till around 1930. Now, the walls are just spectacular. I mean, and that's really why I wanted to really examine the assembly here, because I spent hours just examining the paintings on the wall. Bermuda frescoes, gilded mirrors, high ceilings, relatively small room actually. It's probably not more than 500 square feet. It's a very small space on the Senate side. So let's look at the President's room at the U.S. Capitol on the Senate side.
This is a spherical panorama of the President's room. It was prepared from 8 separate shots. It uses an HDR technique, and there's no supplemental lighting of any kind used in this particular panorama. And this is typical of all the ones that we did for the U.S. Capitol. It's a beautiful room, and it's a beautiful way to show the room. Spherical panoramas have been powered over the years by QuickTime. They can be powered by Java. They can be powered in Flash. And there are all sorts of different presentation techniques. The second part of this video series, part two, talks about the actual software that we used, the cameras that we used, the choices that we made. It lasts about 15 minutes. If you have more of an interest in the technical aspects of the assembly, please watch the second part of this video. But I wanted to just show you this end product so that you had a better idea of what was prepared and how it was actually used. This was part of a multimedia tour, and they were all connected together and to give people a general idea of what the U.S. Capitol looks like before they actually took the tour. Today, you're increasingly seeing more and more spherical panoramas within the context of HD. The 3D software packages over the last 10 years have been able to create this kinds of effect for a while, which is essentially creating a spherical panorama and telling a linear story about the space in a movie format. The use of photographic spherical panoramas to tell a story is rather new, and I'm seeing more and more of it on the internet. It makes great narrative content for HD. It really does. Spherical panoramas like this in an HDR assembly technique are very inexpensive to prepare. They give you a lot of narrative opportunities to talk about the furnishings, the architecture, the structural elements, or as in this case, the history of the space. And it's becoming more and more common for a marketing technique to marry these two technologies, which is, you know, essentially spherical panorama creation and HD video to talk about interior design or architecture. And I encourage you to watch the second part of this video if you have an interest in the actual assembly techniques. But at this moment, this is going to be the end of this video. I would like to thank you for watching this far. And this is Mark Del Sasso. Thank you very much.